Hey there, everybody. Just thought I would share with you some of the underwater footage I got from my favorite pool the other day. I was fortunate enough to get out and be able to fish my favorite pool on Sleeps with the Fishes Creek. But I thought I would share with you some of the underwater footage because it turned out pretty good. And I thought I'd share with you some of the things that I learned from watching it. I won't talk through the entire video. If you want to just have some kind of calming music and watch the fish swim and do their thing, you can scroll ahead a little bit. But yeah, I'm going to share with you some of the stuff I noticed while I was reviewing this footage. One of the first things is, obviously, this pool is full of cutthroats. There's the occasional whitefish who swims through there, but for the most part, they're fairly tightly packed. And the other thing that I noticed is that, for the most part, they are not straying very far to feed. Most of the fish, I mean, they'll move around the pool, but when they're in an active feeding state, they rarely move more than about, let's say, in a 5-foot diameter circle of where they are. The other thing that I noticed and kind of learned from this footage was the old adage that a trout feeds 90% of the time underwater. In the whole 20 minutes of this video, you will probably only see a fish actually rise to the surface maybe a half a dozen times. And there was food on the surface. And these are cuts. They love to rise to the surface to take stuff off. I was actually actively catching fish while this was being filmed on the surface. But you can see that these fish here are mostly feeding on nymphs, and they're moving mostly laterally. Occasionally they make a slightly vertical move to feed on something, but for the most part they are feeding subsurface. So that really confirms to me that if you want to go out and catch a lot of fish, nymphing is probably the way to go. This is just where they're feeding. And like I say, this is a pool I've fished a couple of times, and yes, you can certainly pull them out with a dry, but they seem to be doing a lot of their feeding subsurface. You can see here in the little circle I've put in, you can see that there's a whitefish swimming around in there. He is one of several that moved around. You can also see that some of the fish are beginning to move a little bit vertically and look at stuff on the surface, but still very few that are rising all the way there. I hope you enjoy the footage and enjoy watching this. It can be pretty calming, sometimes a bit hypnotic, just to watch the fish do their thing. So tight lines, everybody. Thanks for watching. Remember, you can follow me on Instagram at Midlife Flysis, also on Twitter at Midlife Flysis. Emails to midlifeflysis@gmail.com. Love to hear all your comments. Love answering those and reading what everybody has to say. So please share your thoughts. And I hope you guys all have continue to have a great summer of fly fishing. Have a good one. Thank you.
Thank you.